Hello everyone, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with a new Shopify tutorial as usual. And in today's tutorial, I'm going to teach you guys how you can add a password protected collection to your Shopify store. So if you want only specific customers to access that collection, you can create a private collection page which will be password protected, just like I have it here. So when you go to private collection, it will ask you to log in. And only those customers who are tagged as private will be able to access this collection. So I've already created a customer in order to show you guys how it will look once they log in to their account. So whoever customer has been given access to this private collection will be able to access this collection page. So once logged in, customer will be able to access the private collection page. Let me add my login and password correctly. So after signing in, the customer will see the account page, and once they click on private collection page after logging in, they'll be able to access the collection page, and no other customer will be able to access this collection page. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. I'm getting only 2% subscribers from the viewers. So don't forget to subscribe. Comment on the video below if you like my videos. So without further ado, let's get into the code. Okay guys, so first we'll go to backend of our Shopify store by navigating to /admin. And once you're logged in and to your Shopify backend, what I'm gonna do first, publish the fresh dawn theme which I recently added in my store. So let's go there first, and that's the theme which I've added. It's the latest version of dawn theme 7.0.1. so if you guys are implementing this code and tutorial to any other theme, it might be slightly different and it might not work. So my tutorials are mostly based on dawn theme because that's a free theme and mostly used in Shopify stores. So if you want me to create tutorial for any other theme, hit the comment and press the like button. I'll definitely create videos with other themes. Okay, so I'm going to publish this one as it's a fresh theme. That's the one where I have already added the code in order to show you guys how the password protected collection page looks like. Now publish this fresh theme. And once this theme is published, I'm going to go and create a private collection page. So click on products and then click on collection. Okay, so as you can see, I have already created a private collection page. So you guys will need to create a collection page. Once the collection page is created, you can then assign the products which you want to display to your customers for this private collection only. And now the second step is to go to your published theme and click on edit code. So that's a published theme. Click on these three small dots and then edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have it as a duplicate, so in case you mess up with the code, you can easily revert it back. Okay, now click on edit code. And once you go to the code backend, it will look like this. And now we will create a new template. Click on this add a new template. Select collection from the dropdown. And select liquid. Now I'm gonna name this private, as it's a private collection page. Click on done. And once your private collection page template is created, I'm going to copy this code and paste it to my private collection page. Don't worry about the code. I will put the link in the video description so you guys can easily copy and paste the code from. Okay, just make sure to have your tag as private, because that we will be adding into our customer in order to make sure to which customers we are giving the access to private collection. Okay, now click on save. And once the file is saved, we will go back to our private collection which we created. And from there, I'm first going to click on refresh here. And now in theme template, select the private, the template which we created in the code. Make sure to select it in the private collection which you guys created and hit save. Once you do that, go to your customer section and then tag the customer which you want to give access to this private collection page. Now, for example, I want to give access to myself. I'm going to click on my customer. And in tag section, as you can see, I have already added private. Make sure to have it same spelling and don't, it's like case sensitive. So whatever you're adding in code here, make sure to have the same tag in your customer section. And once you add the tag, you'll be able to give access to this customer for your private collection. Now, if I go to my private collection page, okay, so that's the old theme. Let's first preview the store. And now, when I click on private collection page, as you can see, it's asking me to log in, right? And once I log in, I'll be able to see the private collection. But as you can see, the login and the text which we have added here is looking a bit ugly. So in order to improve the layout for that, what we're going to do, we'll go to base.css file and add in some CSS code. Again, don't worry about the code. You will find all of the codes in the YouTube video description. So I'm going to paste the CSS code, hit save. And now when I go back to my private collection page and hit refresh, you can see that it's looking more presentable. Now when I click on login, it's asking me to log in. And now I'm going to add my email and password as a customer. And after logging in, when I click on private collection, you can see that I am able to access the collection. And now if I log out from account page and click on private collection, it's asking me to log in. Okay guys, so that's it for the tutorial. If you have any questions, don't forget to ask me those questions in the comment area. I'll definitely try to get back to you guys as soon as possible. I get lots of comments, so please stay put because it's going to take more than 24 to 48 hours. So until next video, have a great day.